Hi guys, welcome to another Techgage video. Today we're going to be taking a look at something a little bit different, the next version of Chaos Group's V-Ray renderer. Well, at least its performance aspect. A couple of weeks ago, Chaos announced a new version of V-Ray that could deliver performance improvements of up to 80%, and given those grand claims, we couldn't wait long before getting down to testing. When it's released in its final form, V-Ray GPU is going to replace V-Ray RT, a renderer originally released in 2009 which became the first to enable interactive rendering in 3ds Max. While RT began out its life as being a CPU renderer, it quickly evolved to become Chaos Group's dedicated GPU renderer, and soon it will shed the RT name to be replaced with the apt V-Ray GPU. A lot has changed over the years, and companies like Chaos have continued to optimize and eke every last bit of performance out of their rendering architectures. With 4.0, V-Ray GPU is going to gain support for a host of new features, including support for NVIDIA's AI denoiser. Unfortunately, because NVIDIA's Volta is required for that feature and we don't have one in our lab, all of our testing has been done on the Pascal-based Titan XP, or rather two of them. Since the CPU V-Ray renderer has also been given an update, we're testing with that as well, and for good measure, some CPU plus GPU tests have also been thrown in. To test out V-Ray 4.0, we grabbed a handful of official scenes that Chaos Group provides its customers, tweaked their render settings slightly, and then directly compared the performance between the 3.6 and 4.0 versions of the renderer. Throughout testing, the GPU fans were pegged to 100% to rule out the chance of throttled clocks, which is especially important in a dual GPU configuration. The CPU cooler pump was also set to performance mode. Between the plugin versions, the settings appeared to be largely the same, with things like noise and sample limits, as well as the number of ray traces, all left intact. By default, V-Ray GPU will utilize every OpenCL or CUDA device in the system except for the CPU, but chances are good that you'll want to enable that since it could offer a notable performance boost. First up is a look at the GPU renderer specifically, using the dual Titan XPs. Simply upgrading from V-Ray RT 3.6 to V-Ray GPU 4.0 delivers huge speedups. Again, anyone with Volta is likely to see the best possible performance here, but to see gains like this on pre-existing hardware is awesome. In most cases, the render time is cut almost in half, but even with the T-set scene, which is the most complex of the bunch, we're seeing really impressive performance. One thing to bear in mind here is that these renders are being done with two high-end GPUs and a high-end CPU, so a 600-second gap between the renderer versions would increase greatly as you move down on through the respective CPU and GPU product stacks. Essentially, if you save 600 seconds between versions on a top-end build, you're going to be saving a lot more than that on a lower-end one. Moving over to take a look at the CPU renderer performance, we can see simpler gains, but gains nonetheless. For some reason, the flower scene didn't budge in rendered time between versions, but the rest showed fair gains. This begs the question, what will we see if we combine the forces of the CPU and GPUs? Fortunately, that's easily done in either OpenCL or CUDA mode, and at least with the CUDA implementation, the aggregate performance is extremely notable. In this shot, you can see both Titan XPs chugging away at 100% usage, and the 18-core i9-7980 doing just the same. Granted, this is a seriously high-end workstation, but CPUs simply shouldn't be discounted for their ray tracing work, and these next results will highlight why. CPUs seem slow for rendering unless you're looking at one like the 7980. In some cases, that chip contributes as much as one of the Titan XPs, and perhaps even more if you look at the 30-minute iteration, where the single CPU contributed more than the two GPUs split down the middle. That's impressive. I mean, granted, the 7980 is a $2,000 CPU, but it's clearly very powerful. On that note, if you'd like to see some AMD Ryzen Threadripper V-Ray testing, please leave a comment to express your interest. Also, if you'd like to see visual representations of this data, I'd recommend hitting up the written article version. You can also find a download there to snag all of the resulting images so that you can better compare them with the help of your trusty image viewer. I spent most of this video talking about the performance gains V-Ray 4.0 can avail, but as the way things go in rendering, few people are likely to look at this new version and judge it by render time saved. Instead, many will look at it from the perspective of, how can I cram more cool stuff into this scene? If not more stuff, then higher resolutions. We're all about 8K now, remember? If you're already a Chaos Group customer and have access to the current version of V-Ray for 3ds Max, you should be able to find the 4.0 download in the respective section on Chaos's website. In time, I hope to add Volta-related benchmarks, but in the meantime, if anyone out there has one and gives this feature a test, please leave a comment and let us know your thoughts. I should also note that I'm in the process of testing other GPUs with V-Ray 4.0, although AMD hardware will unfortunately not be included since none of the scenes I have will reasonably render with the OpenCL API. but since Chaos offers a standalone benchmark, that will allow us to continue comparing them that way, giving both architectures a fair shake. Until next time, thank you for watching, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.